So I do want to go over the products I've used. I went ahead and flattened out my brows using a glue stick, and you can just smooth that over your brows, but there's a ton of tutorials for it. Then I went ahead and just lightly shaded in my eyebrows using my MAC Pen Ultimate Brow Marker. This only comes in one shade, but it works for me. And I went ahead and contoured my face. I've already applied foundation, which was Revlon Colorstay foundation. And to contour, I just used my Coastal Scents Camouflage Palette, and I used the darkest concealer to actually do that. First thing I'm doing is I'm taking my MAC Paint Pot in Soft Ochre, and I'm going to apply this all over my lid from lash line up to my brows and also on my lower lash line. I needed a white base, but I couldn't find my NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil, so I went ahead and used the white shade found on my Coastal Scents Camo Quad Concealer, and I'm just applying this all over my lid, and I did apply it right on top of that Soft Ochre paint pot. Next, I went in with my Coastal Scents 88 Warm Palette, and I'm just taking the lightest shade on here. You could use, there's like four of them, so I just took any light shade. It could be white or off-white. And with a shader brush, I just applied that right over top my white concealer, and I'm applying that all over my lid. So before moving on to all the other steps, I'm just taking some Scotch tape, and I'm going to place this right underneath my lower lash line, just at an angle to wing it out a little bit. Normally I would say to line the ends up with the end of your brows, but in this case I just want it a little bit lower. So now with my angled brush, I just went ahead and dipped that into one of the dark browns found in my 88 Warm palette, and I'm just running this right along the edge of that tape just to make a really thin, fine line. And this is going to be a longer line, not your usual winged out look, but you're going to extend this out a little bit past your brows. And I'm just running this along my lower lash line just so later steps it will all look connected. And then I'm just taking one of these purple shaded browns, and I'm using this the same angled brush. I'm just placing this right above my crease to kind of fake a higher crease. And basically the way I'm shaping this is right where I start, I'm making it the thickest, and as I move in towards the inner corner of my eyes, it's thinning out. Similar to the same way that you would apply an eyeliner on your upper lash line. So taking the darkest red tone brown, I'm applying this with my blending brush, and I'm just using my MAC 217, and I'm placing this right at the base of that fake crease, and I'm just going to slightly fade it towards the inner corner. And then I'm just gonna take this orangey peachy color from my 88 palette, and using a fluffy blending brush, I'm going to apply this right above that just to fade out any harsh lines. Next, I'm just taking a matte black eyeshadow. This is Sugar Pills Bulletproof, and I'm gonna apply this with that same angled brush from the beginning, and I'm just going to begin lightly lining my upper lash line, and I'm starting from the outer edge to connect with that brown, and I'm just going to move this inwards. So this is a really light wash of a black, which we're going to apply eyeliner right over that later in the tutorial. I'm just taking that brush with the eyeshadow and I'm just pushing this out just to wing out my liner. And as I move it out, I stop right where the crease starts and I'm going to fade this into my crease. This is just going to darken up that fake crease to make it look a little bit more realistic. So as you can see here, I just took my same angled brush and that black eyeshadow, and now I'm just going to fill in the outer corner. So this is like the outer V shape of your normal crease, and I'm just filling it in with black, not really caring about any harsh lines or anything like that. I will take care of all that blending later on. Right now, just concentrate on packing on that black color on that outer edge to really darken up that corner. Next, I'm taking my MAC eyeshadow, and this is in Swiss Chocolate, and I'm applying it right to the crease using my fluffy blending brush. This is my MAC 217 again, and I'm just going to blend in that black and brown so there is no harsh line and you will not be able to tell where the black starts and where the brown starts. They should just look like a faded eyeshadow. And then with MAC Soft Brown eyeshadow, I'm taking that on my fluffy blending brush and I'm just going to start blending out the edges. Now I'm just taking MAC's Nocturnal eyeshadow. You would just use any reddish toned plum color. And I'm applying this again with my blending brush and I'm going to apply this right in between the black and brown to kind of blend up towards my brow. The idea here is to layer colors on top of other colors for definition of the eye. Now I'm just taking my black and my angled brush and I'm just gonna go ahead and run it across my tape right where I applied that first line of brown, and I'm just darkening up the brown. And then using my fluffy brush, I'm just going to softly blend that out so it's not too harsh of a line. At this point, the tape is no longer necessary, so I'm just removing that. And if any of the foundation or concealer you've previously applied is removed with the tape, you can go ahead and fix that later. So right now, we're just gonna worry about the eyeshadows. Now with my stiffed angled brush, different from the angled brush I've been using before, I'm just going to fill in my brows so they're darkened, and I'm just using MAC's Espresso eyeshadow to do this. I'm using my Urban Decay Naked palette and I'm going into the lightest shade, Virgin, and I'm using this as my highlight color. I absolutely love this color for this look because it's not glittery, it's not shimmery, it just adds that beautiful metallic shine. Since all of the other eyeshadows I've applied before were pretty much all matte, this just adds an additional pop to your eye. Which for a drag look, anything shimmery, glittery, metallic, all those types of eyeshadows are always best. But you don't want to overdo it because you don't want them to overpower each other. So this is a really nice highlight. So far, this is what the eyes should look like. If you feel comfortable with this as being enough, you can feel free to stop. You can continue on with drag makeup by applying more blush and lipstick if you were going for a more simple look. But as you know me, I am not going to stop here. I'm just gonna keep applying more makeup. Here, I'm just darkening up that line with a little bit more of dark brown, and as you can see, I'm kind of fading it in towards my other eyeshadows. With my black Milani Liquify eyeliner pencil, I'm going to line my upper lash line and I'm just going to stay underneath that initial black eyeshadow. You don't want to go past it. You also want to make sure to line your lower lash line as well as your lower waterline. And of course, we're tightlining the upper waterline. With my angled brush and a little bit more matte black eyeshadow, I'm just patting that right over top that Milani eyeliner pencil, and this is going to set it. You always want to do this with any type of creamy eyeliner. Once you're done with that, you're probably going to have some fallout on your face, so you just want to brush that away. You can use a fan brush or stippling brush. Now with my penultimate brow marker, I'm just going to go in and define my brows a little bit more. I've already curled my lashes and applied my mascara. So now I'm just taking a pair of dramatic long eyelashes and I'm going to put these on. So you could use any type of lashes. Obviously, the longer, the more dramatic, the more full. Now I'm just going to clean up underneath the eye area. I'm just using a foundation brush and I'm going to go into my Coastal Scents Camo Quad into the second lightest shade, and I'm going to just apply this right underneath my eyes, and I'm just going to clean up any of that area where the tape, when I removed it, maybe removed the original concealer I had placed on here as well as the foundation. So this is going to really clean up and brighten the under eye area. Now I'm just going to take a dark contour powder blush and I'm using Max Blunt, and I'm just applying this right over top the original concealer that I used to contour my cheeks. With my e.l.f. Complexion Perfection powder, I'm going to apply this with my MAC 130. And I'm using this as both a highlight and a setting powder for the concealer I applied underneath my eyes. I'm also going to apply this underneath my contour color. Because it's a light shade, it does come off a little bit white on me, so I'm going to use it as a highlight also. Now I'm going to go in with my actual highlighting product in my MAC 130, and I'm using my Bare Minerals Mineral Veil in Feather Light, and I'm just going to highlight my cheekbones. And using that same shader brush I used in the beginning, I'm dipping this into my contour powder, and I'm placing this on both sides of my nose, and I'm going to define my nose. And now I'm just blending it out using my fluffy blending brush, and you absolutely should not skip the blending out of any contour you're doing on your nose. My MAC 130 and just the product remaining on the brush, I'm just going to run this right down the center of my nose to highlight that area. With a mauve or brown lip pencil, I'm going to define the outer parts of my lips. I'm going past my natural lip line and I'm making my lips look more pouty and more full. This is obviously not an everyday makeup look, so you want to exaggerate this type of makeup, and that's what I'm doing. You want to go in with a light lipstick, probably 7 to 10 times lighter than the actual lip liner you applied. I'm using my MAC Peach Stock lipstick. This is a satin finish and I'm applying this right onto my lips with a lip brush. And with my brush, I'm going to slightly fade in that lip liner. Now I'm going in with a lip gloss. This is a lip gloss from Revlon. And I'm applying this onto my finger because that's how I'm going to apply it, right to the center of my lips, top and bottom. Now it's time for the glitz and the glam. I'm taking my NYX glitter liner, and this is just a clear one with white sparkles, and I'm going to start in my inner corner, and I'm going to run this along my lower lash line. And once I'm done with my lower lash line, I'm going to bring it up from the inner corner, and I'm just applying this over top that pale white eyeshadow. You don't want to go into the crease, you want to stay below the crease, just on top of that white, and this looks absolutely stunning. And this is the final look. It is dramatic enough for me, and it's very much drag queen enough for me. You can definitely make this more glammed up, more dramatic with fuller lashes, or just applying a maybe darker lip liner or a darker contour color and just chiseling in the contours and really making those lips pop. But for me, this is absolutely enough. And I hope you guys enjoyed the tutorial and found it helpful. Thank you all so much for watching and subscribing if you have. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye. If you guys are interested in seeing photos of this makeup look, click the link down below in the description box. I have placed a link in there to my blog with the photos.